pre-measured and frozen. I'll put that in there. I have some very cold water ready to set it in case it's necessary. But if it's all just rather slow, you know how it melts. And then we'll come back later. Not only soap, but other bath products. I've dumped that cold water out now. Don't need it anymore. I have not burnt this, which is really good because if you burn it, it's stinky, it's disgusting, and you have to throw it out, which I have not as yet done, but, and here I have the oil with the kale and clay in there, except for the coconut oil, which I'm going to add right now. I had to melt that. I just love coconut oil. It's just so wonderful. Great on the skin. You could even use it straight. I do use it around my eyes straight. Okay, now I'm going to put the lye in. You can see here where I've got my mold ready to go, and so that I don't forget my fragrance oil. I've got that sitting in there because I've made some unscented soaps by accident that I didn't want to make unscented. And so I do that so I won't forget. And that is a mixture of patchouli, lavender, and bergamot. I think it's going to be lovely. And I call this Cloud 9. It's been very popular. Okay, that's in. Now we're going to add the lye water, goat's milk, lye water. And it looks good. I guess when this is burnt, it turns bright orange and stinks really bad. I did that with honey once, had to throw everything out. I burnt it. Now, what I'm going to do with this Cloud 9 is, the plan is that I'm going to pour some in the bottom and make a gold mica line. Put some clouds in there with some white soap tinted with titanium dioxide. So the main batch is going to be blue, but it's going to have clouds in it. All right, now I'm just going to, just for the heck of it, see what the temperature is with this. 69 degrees. Boy, I guess it pays to have your kitchen cool. So it's absolutely not going to hurt to put the fragrance in it. We don't want that fragrance to burn off. All those expensive, wonderful smelling essential oils, we don't want them to burn off. Ooh, that smells lovely. Okay. I have not made soap for a while. I've been busy making bath truffles and body butter and all kinds of stuff, and so I'm a little bit rusty here of making soap. I did make some lard soap the other day, just plain old lard soap that they call old-fashioned lye soap, because I use that in my laundry soap. So I had to make some of that up so that I could grate it later or put it in there. But otherwise, I haven't made soap for, gosh, I'd say at least 6 weeks. So you do get rusty. Okay. We're going to stick blend this. Some people really worry about getting air bubbles in here, but I don't know why, I usually don't. And you see them going like this and all that. The only time I worry about air bubbles is when it's really thick. You know, if I've blended it too much. This has got to have a little bit of body to it, though, or it's not going to work for the design that I want. There's a fine line between having it be too thick and, you know, still workable. And when you're not making soap every day, you kind of lose that touch, you know, so we'll just hope for the best. I just love the saponification process. You know, it's like some mad science experiment. Really, you only need it to be emulsified, and it will later, you know, saponify, but like I said, with this design, I need it a little bit thicker. But I'll tell you what, I'm going to pour my white off right now. In there, I've got a little bit of titanium dioxide, and maybe too much, I don't know. And I mixed it with some of the soap oils. This is going to be the clouds. Then I think I will put some of this ultramarine blue in here. If I can get it out of there. And stir that in. You know, this is kind of a gray. Of course, once you really, this stuff I have found, you have to, that's the problem. If you get it, if you work it too much, and you get it too thick, but you can see those little flex in there. But I haven't noticed that bothering anything. I guess sometimes maybe they stay in there, but can't really tell what color it's going to be until you get all that dissolved. And to me, that's not blue enough. Could put a little bit of a violet in there, but a little bit more and see what happens. There, now it's looking more blue. I don't know if the camera's catching that or not. Really don't want to end up with a gray sky, because that's what we have here in Rockford, Illinois. Most of the winter, we have a gray sky. It's gray today. A couple days ago, the sun shone, and I felt like I had so much more energy with the sun shining. Really? I think I need more. God, that should be enough. Sticking it up now. It's hard to see today, but it looks like that's blue. I just don't know. know if that's blue enough for me. Just add a little bit more. But you can't remove. You can only add. Better to do it a little bit at a time. Is it boring, just blue and white? Well, I'm going to have a gold mica line, so that's going to jazz it up. All right, you can see that it's thickening up there. It's got definitely the trace. Well, I basically learned how to make soap by watching people on the internet and listening to them. So, a lot of you soapers out there that are watching me, hey, you taught me to make soap. I think it's the only art where your competition will teach you how to do it. Is that blue? Does that look blue? Mm-hmm. Or does it look gray?
Gray.
Looks gray. I hate wearing safety glasses. All right, now we really went for it that time. Now does it look blue? No? Still not blue? Because I didn't have it out of the refrigerator. I store it in there because somebody said that if you mix these in oil, there's a possibility that they could go rancid. So that's why I put it in the refrigerator. Okay, let's see if that... That is absolutely not jazzing it up. It's still looking gray to me. But honestly, it is. Now does it look blue? I'm asking my cameraman. He said it does not look blue. What color does it look? Gray? Still looks gray? Daisy. Well, first let me pour some of the... And so that, it really makes a difference how the air temperature of your room makes a big difference. I mean, if I want this soap to gel, I'm going to have to wrap it. First time I made this, I made it so perfect, and I had no idea how lucky I was that I did that. It was sheer luck. I have heard that your soap can fall apart if you get a mica line too thick. And it can split right there at that line, so. The first couple times I used a mica line, I don't think I had enough on there because I was worried about that. It is messy. There's no getting around it. Mica lines are messy. I'm going to clean this up. Go from the side. I do not want. It's just nice if it's cleaned up around here. Catherine, soaping 101, uneven. And that's not going to happen with this batter that is not thick enough. So I'm going to go after this. I know that it's the room temperature. Why this isn't thick enough. If you really want to work with a design, though, it's really nice to have your room cool and the batter cool. It just stays liquefied. But I want this thicker because I want it to be uneven, and I want the microwave to be sort of split. That's not going to happen. This isn't thicker. Say that the room is probably 58 degrees. But it's not something that you can spoon on. Look at it. This is kind of a complicated soap in a way. Got to get some flaws in there. Pretty soon. Now, I'm going to put some clouds in there. Some fluffy, fluffy clouds that we never seem to have anymore. Do I want some of these clouds to break through the mica line? I might put a couple in there doing that. Not right now. Now I'm going to put a little bit more blue on there. You know, this is just a crapshoot. whenever you make something like this. But more often than not, it comes out really nice, so what can you say? Alright, now what I really want to do is heap up some on the side here. And I don't think I'm gonna be able to do that. Maybe I am. Let's try doing that. Because I want to put another mica line in there. I don't want it even. Because the sky is not even. Nothing about the not doing what I want it to do, but it's hard to visualize this. Alright, I'm going to put that aside. Wipe it down again.
Patience.
All of a sudden it's the next day and you're going, I want to cut that! Because I want to see what it looks like. Now we're going to make it really uneven. I got a lot of white left. I have to have, maybe I'll have some streaky clouds. I'll have one that breaks through. Have some more blue. Yeah, this feather is just not as thick as I would have liked it to be. We got a lot of white left here. Ain't this fun? I'm always sad that my mother can't see this because I know she would have really enjoyed this. Maybe she's looking down. Now we'll put a little more sky in. Just about out of sky here. Running short of sky. So I guess we're going to have some cumulus clouds billowing on the top. I'll put a cutting video up after I cut this, whatever that may be. I hate this spatula. I'm just does not want to get in there and scrape. All right, now we'll do some cumulus clouds, and then we're done. And I might put a little bit of design on the top. Just to make it pretty. I don't picture clouds being straight in any way, shape, or form. Oh, that's so pretty. I gotta tap it down. Because it was not very thick. I maybe haven't been tapping as much as I should have, but that's okay. There we go. That is cloud 9. And hopefully it will transport anybody who uses it to cloud 9. So visit theshardsbotanicals.com and check us out. Cutting the cloud 9. Glad we're not waiting until tomorrow. See, the pencil line could have been a little bit more distinctive. Let me get the scale. Firm. It's pretty, not real blue. Definitely looks like clouds. Definitely could have been even bluer. It's pretty dull. Interesting. Very interesting. Everyone comes out different. Interesting. That's got a heart in it. It's more of a greenish color. Maybe it's getting ready to storm. Interesting. That's the fun in this. Never know what's gonna happen. This is like the unveiling. Just the right consistency to cut. I don't think I need to weigh each one now. I know what I'm doing here. Where this bone is good. That was interesting. I like it, it's different. sure didn't come out very blue. But it's pretty anyway. In another month, this will be up on the website. Which will put it right around the first of the year. With it. Well, that's it. TheShardsBotanicals.com.